Hello everyone, very warm welcome to all of you on the platform of Shubhra Ranjan IAS. My name is Akhilesh and I am here for your geography preparation. Dear students, we are approaching towards prelims. Indeed, we get some edge because the prelims has been postponed. But do remember, time spent slowly but passed very swiftly. So be prepared for your D-Day, and as far as a geography mentor, a facilitator of geography, I would like to share some experiences how to approach this prelims. Every week time you happen to feel like get saturated by the course which you have gone through. But indeed, this is the time, this is the hard time to row your boat properly, and this is the time when you have to maintain your calm, composedness as well as good health condition. That's why get hydrated, be hydrated, and don't eat much. Eat easily digestible food. This is the first thing. Sleep properly for a few days, but once prelims approaching, then you can take some kind of stress by reducing your hours. But initially you should go for at least 5 to 6 hours deep sleep, which is very much required. Okay, so take care of your health. This is the first approach I would like to suggest to all of you, and don't panic, don't at all panic. Any battlefield cannot be won leaving the battle. You have to stay over there, you have to stand on, and then things will be all right. Let's begin that how we are going to have the better understanding. You have understanding how we are going to retrieve the information easily at the time of the most panic situation, the most stressful situation in the examination hall. Fine. So first I would recommend that you must have the clarity of the concept. For the clarity of the concept, in the class as well in the notes, you all have noted down, jotted down all those important aspects which we have discussed in the class. So do take care of those concepts. Try to see the between the lines something has been given, and try to find out the kind of concept the book, whether it is NCERT or any book, is going to give you. Apart from it, in the class we have discussed a lot about certain things which you should understand. So go for multiple revision, go for multiple revisit, so that it will help you in retrieval of the information. So revision is your weapon for this prelims examination. Don't go for layman's revision. Go for swift and fast revision. Try to complete the task within the prescribed limit. For that, you must be very attentive during your study duration. So be attentive and go through revising the fact file as well as concept. And do remember, don't only read it, write it. And every time you use your maps, use your figures in order to create a pictographical memory of your concepts. This is very, very good result giving approach. Agar aapne pictographical memory bana rakhi hai, to retrieval of information bahut aasan ho jata hai, and above all, the negative attempts are going to be reduced drastically. So this is what we require. That's why I always suggest go for multiple revision. For example, if you are going through the world regional geography or physical geography, you must go through the basic concepts of plate tectonics, continental drift theory. Once you are going through the plate tectonics, try to connect with the current affair part. For example, if you are going through the plate tectonics, you must take care of transform boundary. And in the class, I have discussed transform boundary of Anatolian plateau, because Turkey have felt a catastrophic earthquake because of that Anatolian plateau and the plate boundary, which is of transform in nature. That's why the themes which is in your current affair, connect it with your concepts. Certainly you will get the question and you will answer it. Apart from it, nowadays they are putting certain questions from astronomy also, especially the solar activity, solar maxima, solar minima, sunspot cycle, solar flares. So they are asking a showstopper question from these topics nowadays, and these topics are also seems to be very relevant because nowadays Indian Space Research Organization have launched Aditya L1 mission to understand more about the surface of the sun. Indeed, sun is the ultimate source of energy, and hence we require some more understanding regarding the sun, because there are solar storms which is approaching towards the earth and may cause more destruction in form of extreme weather condition, heat wave, cold wave and all that. So we must be aware about the solar storms and their activity. So we need to be very careful about this aspect of astronomy, which is part of what geography as well as environment too. That's why do take care of this aspect of what astronomy. Then if you talk about the climatology, again the basic concepts are going to be pivotal. They are putting question in form of statement. So once you are going through the climatology, try to understand the basic concept, revise it and be master of those basic concepts. Then try to see the previous year question paper. Once you see the previous year question paper, identify the themes from where they are putting question. Like they are very fond of asking question from clouds, not the types of cloud, not the rainfall, like their albedo. They are putting questions in form of what? Warming effect. That's why you must be very careful identifying the themes. So they are putting question from cloud, they are putting question from volcano, but their form is different. They are asking question from volcano, like what are the impacts of volcano impacts, that is what environmental impact. So all these things are going to be important in climatology. If you see the recent phenomena, suppose that if you are talking about the climate of India, you understand the monsoon. But if you are not looking to the El Nino, Moduki, these are the teleconnections which is going to affect the Indian monsoon, is going to be important for this particular year. Why? Because this is El Nino year. So India is going to have some kind of impact, Indian monsoon is going to have some kind of impact. If Indian monsoon get affected, obviously it is going to affect the Indian agriculture, and Indian agriculture is going to be the backbone of Indian economy, and hence our economy can also have some kind of kicks, a roller coaster ride. That's why all these aspects as a theme is going to be important. So do take care of this Indian climate along with El Nino, La Nina, El Nino, Moduki. And once you are going through El Nino, Moduki or El Nino, La Nina, so ensure that you must know the South-South Oscillation, Indian Ocean Dipole, as well as Madden-Julian Oscillation. So these are the important aspects from where we can expect some question in climatology part. Apart from it, you are also baffled by the locations. In geography, although it is the heart and soul of what the geography, while you are not knowing the locations, you are not knowing the geography properly. That's why location in geography is quite huge aspect. In optional, we go for this particular topic in a very intensive way. But for general studies perspective, we are not supposed to learn it in a optional geography way. That's why put some attention on the current affair part. If the place is in news, okay, so that place is going to be important. Do take care of those places through the current affairs section and try to find it out. And not only the places is going to be important, but the news itself is going to be important for you. So do take care of those current affair news. Why those places are in news? What are the importance? What are the news associated? So once we talk about the places, there are many entries from environment and ecology perspective. You happen to have so many national park, biosphere reserve, tiger reserve, conservation reserve, Ramsar convention site. There are 4-5 more added out of those 80 sites, 75 were earlier, 5 more added. So those 5 are going to be important. And don't take just the name and the place where they are, but try to prepare it in holistic way. That if there is any river, so do take care of those river. If there is any specific biodiversity, if there is some exclusive biodiversity, do take care of that. If there is any national highway crossing that very national park or wildlife sanctuary, so what are those news. So in if any place is in news, in that perspective you have to cover it holistically, isn't it? Because there are so many national park and wildlife sanctuary as well as biosphere reserve, 18 plus biosphere reserves are there. So you have to be very careful to which you must take care of. Take care of in the sense it should be prepared holistically, not just the names. Okay. And once you are going through the places in news now, so don't read it. Try to make entry on the rough map. You must have the rough map. I always suggest to you in the classes that you must make a map of the world as well as India within 10 seconds. Within 10 seconds, if you are making the proper map, then it is good. And don't go for shortcut. It is only the practice which is going to give you the idea. And once you are going to make those map and you start doing these entries, mind my words, whatever the entries in N numbers is going to be remembered by you. It is your practice that makes you more than perfect. So that is what we require. Fine. So for the map as well as entries, we must take care of current affairs section. Then we will go for those entries and revise it multiple times. Then let's talk about something, this Indian geography part. In Indian geography part, they can put question from location, they can put some question from boundary disputes, or maybe the major area of this Indian geography part is physiography. Indian physiography is the soul of Indian geography. So don't forget that they are putting so many questions on Indian physiography. They may ask question related with Himalaya, Greater Himalaya, Middle Himalaya, Shivalik. They may ask some question related with Trans-Himalaya, they may ask some question related with the glaciers, related with the passes, isn't it? Which pass is connecting Srinagar to Leh, which pass is connecting Srinagar to Ladakh, etc., etc. So you happen to have n number of questions from this physiography. Not only this, Aravali is there, so lot of question can be asked from Aravali, the source of river, Aravali river like Luni as well as Sabarmati is the source. Finding the source in Aravali having less rainfall even than there is a source of river. So all these questions which we discussed in the Indian physiography in the class are going to be very, very important. Not only this, when you talk about Vindhyan, Satpura, Amarkantak, Western Ghat, Eastern Ghat, the names of Western Ghat, like where there is Panchamalai Hill, where there is Anai Modi, as well as in Eastern Ghat you have Shivrai Hill, Javadi Hill, Nalla Malla Hill, Gaharjat Hill, where they are situated, in which state they are situated. Is there any passes in the Western Ghat, Thal Ghat, Bhor Ghat, Pal Ghat, Agombe Ghat, Sen Kota? All these are going to be important, and these passes are connecting some important cities, which is also going to be a question. So do take care of this physiography very carefully, because they are putting 2-3 questions every year from this topic. Apart from it, if you go for the drainage, try to find out the sources of the river, in which state they are moving, what are the tributaries, what are the hydroelectric project over there. It has been already compiled and delivered to you. Try to revise it many times, try to show it on your map. Factually you must be right, and that's why I always insist you to have the practice. Go for so many entries. Don't stop your hand while you are reading. Go some writing on your rough work. This will certainly boost your confidence, not only your confidence, but your retrieval part. And it will certainly reduce your negatives in your UPSC prelims examination. Apart from it, once you are going through the topic like agriculture, major crops, they are putting questions from agriculture and major crop very frequently. They used to ask some major crop, some condition they will give, and then they ask in this condition which crop is going to be the major crop, etc. So you need to find out the major crop. First you need to find out the distribution of rainfall in India and how topography is going to describe this rainfall distribution in India. Once you know it, you easily understand the major crop. Apart from it, if you understand the soil of India, indeed you can see this soil the North India plain, the Punjab Haryana plain, Ganga plain, Brahmaputra plain, and the coastal plain is going to have alluvial soil, isn't it? And what about the red and yellow soil, the part of what? Peninsular India is going to have red and yellow soil, and the part of peninsular India where the Deccan trap is there, you happen to have black soil, cotton soil. So all these soil distribution, if you are in your hand, rainfall distribution in India, then you can easily decipher the kind of agriculture taking place at particular region of India. That would be easy to understand and internalize those information. So always go through the topographical feature, physiographical feature of India, then rainfall distribution, distribution of soil, and once you have the idea of rainfall, indeed you can easily decipher the forest cover of India, the kind of forest where they are going to be more like rainforest. If I say rainforest require massive rainfall, more than 250 centimeter rainfall. So if you have the understanding of rainfall distribution, that Western Ghat as well as Eastern Himalaya is going to have rainfall more than 250 centimeter, obviously the western slope of Western Ghat and Eastern Himalaya is going to have tropical rainforest. Where you are going to find deciduous forest? So as we move from east to west, we find there is decrease in the rainfall distribution, you will find deciduous forest. In the extreme west, you happen to have xerophytic vegetation. So on the basis of this rainfall distribution, you can easily decipher the vegetation, and once you have the understanding of vegetation, indeed you require some constitutional provision for conserving all these resources. So you must be clear about the different acts like 1927 Forest Act, Forest Conservation Act 1980, 2006, Forest Dweller Right Act, okay, Recognition of Forest Dweller Right Act 2006, and then CAMPA in 2016. These are acts which you should internalize in your memory. Why these acts were passed, what are the provisional feature, why those features were included in the act, why the act is going to identify the recognition, recognizing the forest dwellers, right? Why these need happen? So once you have the understanding that yes, we conserve the forest from the forest centric approach, and we are leaving the people who are native to the forest, we are actually taking their rights. If you remember the Kantara movie, you will find that the person who was the hero also was saying, why I should take permission from them? They should take permission from me. They came to my territory. Why I should go for it? Isn't it? So these kind of clashes you will find in the forest area. Those people, their right were not recognized because of corruption. They were persecuted, you can say. And that is what irony of it. And that's why they started armed rebellion against us. And that is something which is also the connection with Naxal, revolution over there. So the Naxal infested area is going to have the tribal area. Those tribal area haven't recognized forest right. So it was the need of the hour to recognize the forest right of forest dwellers so that they can easily understand their authorities. So four rights were conferred in 2006. So this was the need, because earlier our conservation approach was what? Forest centric, or you can say biodiversity centric, but we, the human being, are not recognizing us. That's why these are the problems. So we need to understand those correlation, why Forest Act was there, then Conservation of Forest Act was there, then what are the concept included, like there was reserve forest, there was conserve forest, then there was conservation reserve, community reserve. So all these concepts came in these acts day by day as the need perceived. Okay, fine. And then people are going for deforestation, so for developmental activity. That's why there is a need of what? Afforestation drive, and for that the project has to be passed only when afforestation ensured. For that, the party was charged with funds, and those fund has to be managed. And in order to manage those fund, what happened? There was Kempa. No? So all these chronological study you must be in your mind. It will help you in your mains examination as well as prelims examination. For prelims, these are the milestones while you are studying the different act, different provision, as well as in environment and ecology, you will go for multiple, what you can say, protocol and all that, and there are conference of parties. So you do take care of those milestones in particular parties, especially the recent one. Okay, so these are the things you should go for, and they are asking less question from industry as well as population. So for prelims examination, these are the topic of less importance, but yes, all other topic you must be prepared for that. So make revision your weapon, bar bar revise karein, har bar revise karein, or be calm, be patient, things will be all right. Thank you very much.